Hello everyone, my name is Dan from Solopress, and welcome to our tutorial for how to resize an image in Photoshop as part of our graphic design and tutorial series. We'll be creating a lot of free content for you, so make sure you click subscribe and the bell icon to be notified of when we upload. Today we'll be utilizing a feature called Smart Objects, and they've been in Photoshop since 2005, so unless you're still running Windows XP with Photoshop 7.0, you'll have this feature. So here I have a basic canvas with two identical photos on it, one simply a duplicate of the other. Just as an extra keyboard shortcut for you, you can duplicate any item in Photoshop by selecting the layer and pressing Ctrl-J if you're on Windows, or Command-J if you're on Mac. Now you might be thinking that resizing an image in Photoshop is inherently easy. Simply enable Free Transform by pressing Ctrl or Command-T, and then drag the corner pins to whichever size you'd like the image to be. Or if you're in an older version of Photoshop, you might have to hold Shift to make sure that Photoshop constrains the proportions of the image so you don't end up with a squished photo. The problem with conventional image resizing is that it's destructive. Your image is made of pixels, and once you've resized an image, those pixels won't have shrunk, the image will have shrunk, and you'll have only retained enough pixels for the resized image. So I'm going to run you through an example of this using controlled parameters. Here we have an image of a car going through a puddle. I've chosen this because there's a decent amount of detail in it, lots of water droplets and in-focus objects. We'll do the conventional image resize on the left. Firstly, let's enable Free Transform by either selecting the layer here, then going to the Edit tab and go to Free Transform. Alternatively, as before, we can just press Ctrl or Command-T. You'll see the bounding box for the image and the grab handles, but on the selection bar, there's now a different set of parameters that we can accurately adjust. We'll be changing the percentage value from 100% to 10%. But firstly, let's check that the Maintain Aspect Ratio box is selected. This will mean that when you change one of your values, it'll also change the other. Then we'll press the Enter key that's furthest right on the keyboard, or the tick here. This will commit these changes to the object you've just changed, and we'll leave that there for now. The other layer, on the right-hand side, we're going to turn into a smart object. This is a non-destructive process, and the best way I can describe it is that it keeps the image at its original size, but acts like it's being resized. The benefit to this will become apparent shortly. To turn it into a smart object, select the layer, right-click, and select Convert to Smart Object. Then we'll follow the same steps as before. Making sure the layer is selected, we'll enable Free Transform by pressing Ctrl or Command-T, ensuring that the Maintain Aspect Ratio box is selected, and then changing the scale from 100% to 10%. Since the left image is now rasterized at 10% of its original size, this means that it's lost 90% of its information, whilst the smart object has retained it all. It's much easier to see the difference if we scale both images back up, and so we'll change the value of the left image back up to 100%. But hold on, the image is now showing as 100% scale. That's because when the image got rasterized, this 10% image size became the full image. And when we rescale it by scaling up to 1000%, we can see that the small amount of information left leaves the image looking very blocky. When we then commit changes by clicking on the tick, Photoshop attempts to smooth out the image to create detail, but we're too far gone for it to even look plausible. Transversely, when we look at the scaling options for the smart object, it's still showing at 10%, so when we change it back to 100%, the image scales back to its original size, and more importantly, with zero detail loss. Comparing the two, we can see that all of the detail is gone on the left image. Clarity on the water droplets has entirely disappeared to the point where it just looks like smoke, and you can barely make out the individual spokes of the wheels. Even the rocks have lost all definition. And there you have it, the best way to resize images in Photoshop. If you found this video useful, please leave a like, and if you've got any questions or suggestions, please feel free to comment them. We're creating all kinds of tutorials for Adobe programs, so hit subscribe and enjoy our content. My name's Dan from Solopress, and thank you very much for watching.